All right, welcome back, and today we are going to be taking a look at our YouTube video manager. The way you get to your video manager is you're gonna click this icon at the top, always making sure you are logged into the correct account. Go to your Creator Studio, and on the left I see these options. I'm gonna go ahead and click on videos. And here I am, it's in the video manager. And I see all these symbols on the side related to these videos. You can always mouse over them and I'll show you what the symbol means. YouTube is very, very good about that. So if you ever have a question, just hold your mouse over it, see what it says. As you can see, you know, a closed lock is private, open lock is unlisted, the world is it's published. I've got little money signs for if it's monetized and little check marks to tell me if it's published or a little clock to tell me if it's scheduled to publish. If I want to edit a video, it's important that I click on edit, this little button here. If I actually click on the thumbnail of the video, it's just gonna take me to the page where the video actually starts playing. So when I want to edit a video, I'm careful not to click on that. You know, I can always get to the edit screen from there too, but it's a little more irritating, especially that autoplay on YouTube. So here we are, this is what it looks like when we're getting ready to edit a video. Of course, you can change all your metadata in here if you've uploaded a video as unlisted, private, or scheduled because you still need to do the back-end work. This is the way I'd recommend you do it. Now here, notice we can change the privacy settings. Quick tip, never go from private or unlisted to public. If you just do it that way, it doesn't actually go out to all your subscribers. What's much better to do is just to schedule it for an hour or 2 hours in advance and then set it to do that. And then it goes out to all your subscribers. Sometimes if that little scheduled setting is grayed out, it might be because your video is set on unlisted. So actually if you change from unlisted to private, then you can schedule the video, one of these fun little bugs on the back end of YouTube. So this is the way we can do this. And also remember, when we're filling in our tags here, if I want to do a multiple word tag, I just make sure that after I type my little phrase, I put in a comma or enter to get that tag to stick with itself. If you ever want to put a symbol in on your title or in your description, the way we do that is we insert a symbol in a Word document and then you copy and paste it over. And that's how you get these fun little symbols in there. And they can really just make your video stand out.